All right, this is part of the Shabbat study number 18 in the Hebrew Mishpatim and in the Amharic Sherat. In the English, it's called Judgments, and in Spanish, Derechos. Chapter 22, verse 28 is interesting because it says, "Thou shalt not revile the gods." Thou shalt not revile the gods, the Elohim, because like I was saying, yes. Up in that mount, it wasn't just Moses.
It was all of us. Like, oh, congratulations!
The gods were sent down, bearing inside of their flesh the tablets, not on stone, but in our heart.
Amen.
Because we ascended in prayer, in acceptance to His will, and reviled the king and saw, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Root of David, hath prevailed.
Yay.
To open the book and loose the seven seals. And so because we have seen that, and as we see that, he shows us Christ, and Christ reflects the Father, and so they are one. And because they are one, and the Son said, if you be with me, I make a space for you when I go to the Father, so we be one in the Father. So then we don't hear the judgments, we hear Christ. We hear Christ giving the blessings. And it says, do not revile the gods, do not revile the Elohim, my children, when they be sent.
Mm-hmm.
And then it says, nor curse the ruler of thy people. See, the ruler, in all sincerity,
is the ruler
is Christ. Yeses. Because even though the Father is the one that is the King of Kings, the Father in 1936 handed over the kingdom, lest it be corrupted, to Jesus Christos. Saying, what's a kingdom? A kingdom is the same word as government. It's the same word as reign. It's an influence of authority over.
Exactly.
It's a command that responds to your obediently to your will. That's a kingdom. It doesn't have to have a castle. It's just obedience. It's a government. So now, 1936, His Imperial Majesty said before the League of Nations,
and that's the
there is no government, including mine.
Yeah.
Upon this earth, he didn't say including mine, but when he said there is no government upon earth, now the government of the kingdom of David was established in Ethiopia, no doubt. I'm not saying that that's not the case, but even that one, he said, there is no government upon earth that is superior anyone to another, except the only superior government upon earth is the government of our Lord Jesus Christos, the government of the heavens.
And here it is. Because His Majesty was speaking to the powers. Now, there's different hierarchies in the demonic realm. It's on the switch and flip and perverse, right? So there's different leagues and regions. You know, the guy was possessed, he's like, I'm legion. You know, it goes up to, I don't know the stratifications, but powers is the things that rule other instruments of power on the earth. You know, they're giving it to them by Satan.
Well,
so
yes.
This is who he was talking to.
The nations.
Father
League.
Was like, burn fire. And in the powers, I'm giving this power, just like we have any problems. Oh, Father, I got a car accident. Oh, Father, they're suing me. Oh, Father, I'm about to lose my job. You know? Oh, send an angel, right? Yeah. Send, you know what I'm saying? Help me out here. No. Father knew that he was dealing with the highest form of demonic worship. Powers, so he put it in Christ's hands, like, oh, this is not my fight. You're not supposed to be like, oh, it's not my fight, it's Josh's fight. And that's even when the fight is even better, like, you know, when you take it personal, you're like, oh, you know, say, let it go, don't take it personal. But when Father said, oh, no, you know what, I'm putting this in my son's hands right now, this is it, no government over the heavens.
So now,
and he declared it.
So basically, what did he destroy? He destroyed the society, the league, the society, the Gentile world system.
Satan's system.
It powers and yeah, it don't matter.
Shit flows downhill. Look at Bernie Madoff with all that money. That shit went from one top and everybody came crumbling down. Like the fucking towers. That shit hitting the top, and the shit came crumbling down. Just a visual, just to give Aya Knight a visual. Yes. So the shit was, he hit it at the hat. What year was that he hit the powers and gave it over to Christ? Like, this is not my fight, this is Christ's fight. Power.
And he already won.
Yeah.
So we win.
Because he won when he was low, when he was at, just like Paul said, I'm happy, sufficient, and when I'm the lowest and the happiest. You know, I'm content. I'm content. Like, I'm chill. Because Christ, as the Mashiach of Aaron, the lowest, the Kohanim.
No, not the Mashiach of Aaron.
Oh, the
Aaron Kohanim. Was a bad representative. Well, you know.
I know, but remember the Dead Sea Scrolls that busted out in 1947 when His Majesty came on the scene. Yeah. He opened them scrolls. Yeah. That's how people were like, two Mashiachs, second, the king. No, wait, that shit is real?
Yeah, but yeah. Aaron. Exactly. Aaron is not the one, though.
No. Aaron was a type. Just like with David and
that's all I want to hear.
Yeah. These are all types, like you're saying. Yeah. Christ showed.
But the fulfillment
is was Christ who came, boom, and highly hey, I'm the best high priest you'll ever have, because you know what? It's all about forgiveness. Come in. Oh, you kill me? Temple, the veil is ripped, motherfucker. Ripped, because I done gone somewhere else. You're done. I went into the spirits and took up the bottom worst of the spirits who are even, those demons are even enslaved by fucking Satan.
Yeah, because you went down into Sheol.
Yeah, come on. So he said, I'm going to go to the lowest, to the untouchables. Like, let's think about East India. It's cultural. I'm going to go down the hell to the lowest.
To Sheol.
Sheol. And he let those lowest.
Yeah, to free. Exactly. So did not we just speak on how the smoke rose, ascended from the furnace.
And that's why they're like, how long, Father, how long? In Revelation, like, oh, nah, you wait, the show's not over.
So from the bottomless pit came up a smoke.
A smoke of prayer, like, oh my God.
Hey, maybe that's what happened. A few of the locusts got out.
You know, like when you open up.
Hey, maybe a few of the locusts got out. Like,
yeah.
You know, in the.
Oh my gosh, New York. The New York sewer, dude. That shit opens up.
Yeah, well, the Twin Towers, exactly. You know, when they fell, how it was burning for luck.
Exactly.
But that's why Babylon is falling, it's a process.
Exactly.
It's not it just happened.
And then her father hit him in the head, and when? After the lowest, and they took that, and they took advantage of it, and they did the whole world colonialism, and they enslaved the Hebrew people, and the Ethiopians, the Kohanim, the Ugan, the Levites, who are confused, and that's why they've been they didn't know about the key of David. They kind of got lost. They had made fake copies, that, you know, that's why that shit's all fucking Tashi Turvy, but that's okay. That even the Haitian Revolution was a example of how, and then Ethiopia. So look how close. Haitian Revolution, 1896, Ottawa, boom. It's been really quick turnaround. So yeah, I give praise this the most. 1804, 1896, 1930.
Yep.
Five. Yeah, man. No. And so he burned father in Davidic Mashiach, casted the power. So here you go. Look, you blow up the bottom and you blow up the top. The system's done. You feel right, son?
Yeah, check it. Mm-hmm. Don't once claim that the towers were brought down from explosive bombs from the bottom.
And the top.
And then they came crumbling down.
And so, it's on the dollar bill.
Yeah, thou shalt not revile the gods. That's the angels. That's I and I. And we ain't making ourselves to be nothing.
We're
just in the image and likeness.
We're just doing the message. And you know, we're about the minimum economic security for the sages, but if Jah gotta make it maximum economic security for the ages, yo, it's done. And we're just a message.
And it says, nor curse the ruler of thy people. Who's the ruler? The ruler is the high priest.
Yes,
so that's the Trinity right there. Because who's speaking? Moses. Mm-hmm. What's he speaking? What God told him to write.
Right.
So who's the ruler? Aaron, the Mashiach, the high priest.
Yes, sir.
And who the Elohim, his elect.
Uh-huh.
So the reason I can say even this old Scofield reference study Bible gives us with that same verse when it says ruler, it sends us to Acts chapter 23 verse 5 where Paul, and I think he's being a smartass, because he says then said Paul, I was not brethren that he was the high priest, for it is written. Mm-hmm. See, he's making fun of them. Because he knows that Yeshua HaMashiach is the high priest.
Exactly.
So he's all like, oh shit, my bad. I didn't know, because you know, do not revile the ruler, do not revile the... But yeah. It says, then said Paul to him, God shall smite thee,
yes,
thou whited wall.
Uh-huh. What did Christ say? You guys are white, painted and sepulchres of wild and dead men.
Well, they're like Egypt. They're coffins, yeah. Decorated from the outside, but exactly. The corpse is within.
Yeah, the dead. Yeah,
but they're whited, sepulchre. Like whitewashed. Exactly. White, the wall, white, you know, kind of
whitewashed sepulchre.
And then whitewater. For sittest thou to judge me after the law, and commandest me to be smitten contrary to the law? Uh-huh. You hypocrite! And then they got on his case, and they that stood by said, revilest thou God's high priest? Oh shit, wait a minute, my bad, I didn't know, you know.
Oh yeah,
so that's what he said, you know. He said, like, I didn't know, brethren, that he was the high priest, for it is written, thou shalt not speak evil of the ruler of thy people. But he knew that he was mocking them.
Exactly.
He knew, they knew, they couldn't interpret left from right.
Exactly.
Like, so he was like, I'm my bad in that case. Oh, I should keep my mouth shut, you know.
Exactly.
Because I've heard people say that Paul kind of like knew his place and stuff. No, he was making fun of them.
Exactly.
But they can't tell the difference.
Exactly. Exactly.
So, I mean, but no, totally what? Check it. Let's.
And then he tells him that Jael smite them. Don't he tell him afterwards? That's just kind of like answered the sarcasm right after. Like
well, let's see. Then let me see what it says. It actually says Paul appeals to the Pharisees, but when Paul perceived that the one part was Sadducees and the other Pharisees, he cried out in the council, men and brethren, I am a Pharisee. So then he appealed to them. Kind of like, hey, I was like you, just like I use every opportunity to be like, hey, I did not believe in Christ.
Exactly.
I did not believe in religion.
Exactly.
I was like you.
Exactly.
I was like you. My mom was tripping out when she was walking down the hall, and my little brother's the little sister of her baby mama, she was asking me questions, and I was doing a painting of, and I was explaining, oh, this is when Peter says, Lord, can I walk on water? And yes, as Crystal says, come. Mm-hmm. And then the actual, like, you know, the painting that's
favorite.
Upstairs.
I love it.
You know, and Yeshua is telling him, he's got the scripture in his heart, and he's saying, Peter, why did you doubt?
Yeah.
And my mom was walking down the hall, and she laughed, and I turned around, and I'm like, what you laughing at? She's all like, she just nodded her head, like, I can't believe my eyes.
My son?
This is not... This is not the demon. This is not
the demon.
The demon that I raised.
What'd you do with him? What's going on?
Where's my son?
I got meds.
You know, I do testify to that.
What's going on? Are you in a cult?
But now, here's important to recognize. This is the connected with the Elohim. Now, the same Shabbat study, chapter 23, verse 20, instructions and promises concerning the conquest of the land, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, you know, root of David, the root has conquered the land, you know, the root, you know, the earth, you know, kind of. So it says, behold the lion. Now it says, I send an angel before thee. But what, so this angel no doubt is talking about Yeshua HaMashiach, but what did he do? Go ye preach to the nations. So he scattered us as a seed, so that we would be cut off from our selfish selves in Israel, and we manifest free from that root that was corrupt, and we're born all across the world.
And veiled, almost like you were saying, like Amalek, but different, veiled in like in glory.
Well,
because it's all a fair game. You know, if you read that, it's like, there's a number of children of light and a number of children of darkness, and there's a little bit of grace.
So that, because what did the wicked do all the time when children were gonna, they started killing all the babies.
Uh-huh.
But if we scatter, who are you gonna kill? You're gonna kill the whole world.
Exactly.
You don't know. You can't attack a people.
They have a couple of great people.
You cannot attack a people that you don't know where they are.
Uh-huh. Exactly.
You have to wait for the harvest to be ready so that you can tell
what's the weed and what's the wheat.
So you can be, but it's so hard nowadays because Babylon is so confused. Confusion is so to its ultimate level that you no one can really tell until only the angels,
by the fruit.
Only the Elohim that be like, listen, dude, I'm telling you, Haile Selassie first is the King of Kings, you know?
Who cares? And but, at this point, I ain't proselytizing. You know, I know where I'm going, peace.
That to keep thee in thy way and to bring thee into the place which I have prepared, thou shalt indeed obey his voice. What I want to express, then he says, and later on he says, and ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy waters, and I will take thy sickness away from the midst of thee. But what I want to get into is that thou shalt obey, the place where I prepare, notice how, where I prepare, mm-hmm. I will prepare a place. So don't get caught up in Jerusalem, turn it, no, mm-mm. A place that I'm going to prepare in spirit and in truth. Uh-huh. Don't get caught up on your own imagination.
Yeah, you're on the move, and that's why they had them in the desert. It's on the move. It's the
yeah, it's thing. I'm gonna pick up your tent and let's roll. Let's pick up your cross.
Don't get comfortable, because when you get comfortable, that's when you get in fucking trouble.
Now
you get caught up in the snares.
So just to annihilate this whole Jerusalem. Listen, everyone's fighting for Jerusalem, right? For 2,000 years, Jerusalem, the people that ran it, the priesthood, Stephen testified to this. All the, like most of the prophets tasted, which one of them did they not kill? They killed every single messenger that Jah sent.
Yeah.
Each one of them. Yeah. You know, that's what Stephen is telling them. Mm-hmm. And when Stephen was going to say, and now you've killed the son of the... And that's when they stole him.
Oh, cut it.
They killed,
cut it,
the, they cut. Killed them before he could finish.
Killed the son.
That's chapter 7 of...
Wow.
Chapter 7 of Acts of the Apostles. And that's what changed Paul, because Paul saw that whole thing. They laid his clothing.
Don't want to say
See, Paul later confesses that he approved that murder. Mm-hmm. But he couldn't explain it to himself, because he knew the scripture.
There he's good.
He was like... he was really affected by that.
Exactly. He was on the sidelines before they could say...
He was a persecutor of Christ.
Exactly.
So, he saw, watch, well, actually, the council, for we have heard him say that Jesus, watch, I'm going to say this. Chapter 6, Acts of the Apostles, I'm going to start with verse 11. Then they suburbed men which said, we have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. Now, hold up. Because earlier it says that they pay these people. Now, well, you know, just going forward. And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes and came upon him and caught him and brought him to the council and set up false witnesses. Mm-hmm. And that's part of that actually, I give thanks that I landed on that page, because I wasn't looking for that one. Because it says in this Shabbat study, Mishpatim, it says, chapter 23, thou shalt not raise a false report. Put not thine hand with the wicked to be an unrighteous witness. Thou shalt not follow a multitude to do evil. Neither shalt thou speak in a cause to decline your... after many to rest judgment. So it's not a democracy. If a million people say that Haile Selassie first is not God, guess what? That doesn't make it right.
Exactly.
That doesn't make it true.
It's a million people that are wrong.
So just because everyone's saying, he's guilty, crucify him, I'm going to be like, nope, as for my part, no, I vote don't.
Exactly.
Because, not because the majority is voting the same thing means that they're correct.
Exactly.
So then it says... Then and set up false witnesses. This man sees it not to speak blasphemous words against the holy place and the law. Holy mm-hmm. place, right? That's the holy place that you choosing. Mm-hmm. But listen, what happens after that? So, for we have heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth shall destroy this place and shall change the customs which Moses delivered us. And all that sat in the council, looking steadfastly on him, saw his face as it had been the face of an angel. So here's Stephen, one of the first sent, you know, that's testifying, that a martyr. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So this is right here. I give thanks to Jah. I wasn't thinking to say this, but what it's saying is, what I'm saying is true. The Elohim, do not revile the Elohim, the angels, mm-hmm. the ones that are sent, because mm-hmm. he sent us to testify. Mm-hmm. So don't expect Jesus Christ to come and knock at your door. Hey, I'm here, the second coming. Oh, by the way, it's not the second, it's the third. I'm in the third power of the Trinity. You ready? You got time, as a matter of fact?
Here's your business card. You know,
those that look for him the second time.
Him, H-I-M.
Hebrews chapter 9, it's towards the end, those that look for me the second time.
Exactly.
What, you expect them to go look for you?
Exactly.
Search the scriptures.
You need to know what it looks like.
So towards the end it actually says, which of the prophets have, this is chapter 7, Acts of the Apostles, verse 52, which of the prophets have not your fathers persecuted? And they have slain them which showed before of the coming of the just, of Jesus Christ's one, mm-hmm. the righteous one, of whom ye have been now the betrayers and murderers, mm-hmm. who have received the law by the disposition of angels and have mm-hmm. not kept it. Mm-hmm. And then the first martyr and the first mention of Paul. When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, mm-hmm. and they gnashed on him with their teeth. But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, looked up steadfastly. That's him ascending, you know, like kind of. Mm-hmm. And then he saw us on the mount. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, but the ones judged unrighteous, they saw thundering, mm-hmm. and the earthquake, and, mm-hmm. and the trumpet sounded louder, mm-hmm. and smoke and fire. They saw judgment. They saw hell. Exactly. But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of God, and yes, standing on the right hand of God, and said, behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Wow. And they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears. Remember I said the trumpet, you shut up.
They don't want to see it.
Yeah, and
wow,
hear it.
Wow, he was given the vision. Wow.
And ran upon him with one accord, murder, like Cain since the beginning. They took on judgment themselves. They thought they were God.
Stop their ears.
They're going to take life and cast them out of the city and stoned them. And the witnesses laid down their clothes at a young man's feet whose name was Saul. So Saul is like...
yeah, like, what the fuck? You know when you're in a gang and you get jumped and shit and they murder some motherfucker, and then it takes you a while to be like...
But Paul was really tripping out on this.
He said a young man.
Paul. It says Paul. The young man Paul.
It's like he got older. And living this way.
Oh, my bad. Saul.
He was a youth. Not a youth, but you know how it is when you have that turning point.
No, yeah, he was a youth. Youth in the faith.
Exactly. So, youth and all that.
So he was Nazi about it. Exactly. Oh, you can't talk. You know, exactly. Moses. But then he got it. When he saw this, he was like, oh, shit. I can't explain this because actually everything he said is right.
So what they just fucking did was wrong. Dude.
Yeah, so I can't explain this one.
Exactly.
He was really meditating on
this. Exactly. Mm-hmm.
From now on.
Like, it was them.
So, what I was, you know, part of the...
give thanks. And then Paul, again, represented that little mix of everything, because he could speak languages, he was a Hebrew, he had knew his tribe, he was like us in America. I'm Ethiopian, Western Haitian.
I'm a U.S. citizen.
And, no, but here's the situation. Like, I'm a Haitian American. My great-grandfather is a noble. My grandfather used to be the government. You know what I'm saying? Like, run the Totonwaku.
So
I know who I am on the thing of that. My great-grandmother did dancing with the troop, and they moved to Cuba. My grandmother knew Celia Cruz, Celia de la Croix. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I used to be Asian and Creole, and I'm an American citizen on top of that. You know what I'm saying? Just all these little things.
You just had to put that out there.
You know,
well, mama, you know.
But on the planet, but we all like us.
We are like
that. I'm like, but somebody, I'll be walking down the block, somebody will be like, oh, that's a regular nigga bitch from Oroville. No, my name is X, Y, and Z. I'm from IET. You know what I'm saying? This is my family background. Check it out. Oh, and by the way, my great-great uncle wrote the Haitian National Anthem. But just saying. You know what I'm saying? Like, that was how Paul is. But I'm just saying, and no, you can't take me because I got rights. And also, I'm a Levite. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So Paul represents that. Like, what? No. Just on the front. That ain't cool. his whole consciousness was like left up. I'm just saying, we can erase that part, but I'm just giving an example.
No,
just
I won't. Like us. I don't care.
He just from Mexico. You know what I'm saying? But on the groundation level, all right, it don't matter because we know who our real father is. Yes, Abba Kaddush and Kaddush, because we give up all those things. But Paul was like, hold up. You know what I'm saying? But then he brought it back to Christ because it don't even matter. Because it was like the son of the creator. The one that all this stuff was made for in the beginning. What? Yeah, really, man? Not do that.
Watch, I want to go into the Torah portion that's for the prophets. It's in Jeremiah.
Tell me.
Now, actually, it's two small portions. No, one small. It's chapter 33, book of the prophet Jeremiah, verse 25 to 26. And chapter 34, verse 8 to the end, verse 22. But I want to, I'm not just going to go into 25 and 26 of chapter 33, book of the prophet Jeremiah, because the whole chapter is interesting. But this, see, it's about the title here says the great prophecy concerning the Davidic kingdom. So, you know, in those days and at that time, I will cause the branch of righteousness to grow up to David. But, you know, that I want to go into this, which is very interesting. Verse 18, neither shall the priests, the Levites, want a man before me to offer burnt offerings and to kindle meat offerings and to do sacrifice continually. Now, yes, IT, no doubt. Once they receive the message, if they are in spirit and in truth, then those that amen, I won't and amen, then no doubt they are.
And you know there's a lot of Syrians in Haiti.
Well,
generation.
All I'm saying,
what is the impact biblically on that? All that shit.
What I'm saying is that it really doesn't matter where you're from.
It's true.
Because the Levi paid tithes to Melchizedek.
Okay.
And that's just an example.
Oh, yes. The Gentiles.
So, you know, and so the Levites weren't even... See, before the Levites, Ras Alonso Tafar. Mm-hmm. Before even Melchizedek, I am. Before Genesis 1:1, I am. So, you can't go farther than that. The Levites are way after. Even so, my authority is higher than theirs. But they can claim... See, they can claim Levite authority, or they can claim eternal authority. You know, but you're not in proper order if you don't just receive the revelation of the time, because that means you're neither. You're just not. You know, it doesn't matter. It don't matter if the in a generalized sense, Haitians they do represent the Levites, but not all Israel is Israel.
Exactly.
So it becomes that simple.
It
becomes a self judgment. Mishpatim, you judge for yourself if you find yourself worthy of being who you want to be.
Uh-huh.
I am that which I am. Nothing can change that. So basically, if this is true, then this day, I and I are claiming Levi priesthood right here and more. But let's stick to Levi. Yeah, we still have a high priest. We don't lack that to do this. But what about the Jews? They don't have a high priest. They don't have a temple working or functional,
exactly.
Operating.
Huh.
We do.
They try to do the third temple when we were in the third.
And power of the Trinity. The first power of the Trinity, which is a Trinity.
Exactly.
And the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah saying, thus saith the Lord, if ye can break my covenant of the day and my covenant of the night, and that there should not be day and night in their season, then may also my covenant be broken with David my servant, that he should not have a son to reign upon his throne.
Mm-hmm.
And with the Levites, the priests, my ministers, check it out. What he's saying, people can't really understand this, but let me just enlighten ones with the glory of Jah. I glory in the Bible, he said, Haile Selassie first.
Mm-hmm.
See, he's saying, if you can break my covenant,
mm-hmm.
and... if you can break my covenant of the day and my covenant of the night,
because
I shall go before thee in a pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day.
Mm-hmm.
So no excuse,
mm-hmm.
day or night, I'm here,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
today or tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
See, I don't
from sunset.
Yeah,
to sunset.
I don't break my promises.
Mm-hmm.
You break it for me,
uh-huh.
not accepting me to be here today, present this very day in the person of Haile Selassie first, resurrecting the true and living Son of God, mm-hmm. which is Yeshua HaMashiach. Mm-hmm. Today, right now, not yesterday, not 2,000 years ago, right now. Mm-hmm. See, you are the one that breaks his covenant for him. He didn't break it. Exactly. So it's saying that if you play God and you say, well, there's, that he's not manifested, we're waiting.
Exactly.
Then you call... Then,
look in the sky. No, you go, Moses. No, we'll just go and look on this
Then
side.
It says, then... May also my covenant be broken.
Mm-hmm. You ain't ready.
Well, check it out. It's interesting. It says, thus saith the Lord.
It's almost waiting for the bridegroom. It's like the rising and goes to the wedding, dude. And now, Moses, tell us how the food went.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
That's what Christ said. Watch, the whole wedding thing.
Watch, it's one covenant. Mm-hmm. If ye can break my covenant. So it's not your covenant to break.
My covenant.
So if ye can break my covenant of the day and my covenant of the night.
It's a mystery.
I'm going to reveal it. Mm-hmm. And that there should not be day and night in their season. Is there not day and night?
Every time.
Every day, every every night. So you may have broken my covenant.
Take this earth out of rotation.
But, no. But it's not your covenant to break. See, you just broke your branch from the tree.
Until you can make it stop, the sun go up, and then make the sun.
And then it says, then may also my covenant, it's my word, be broken. But since day and night has not ceased to be. Then it stop fantasizing.
Is that why they messing with the space all the time? Are they?
I don't really care. I don't really.
But like how they try to change times and laws.
I really don't care. There's still a day and there's still a night.
They're delusional. They're crazy.
Then may also my covenant be broken with David, my servant, that he should not have a son to reign upon his throne, and with the Levites, the priests, my minister. So basically, he's making fun of us. He's like saying, "Listen, if you can break my covenant and no longer there's day and night." Then, only then, if you could stop it from being day and night, then there will be no son of David to sit upon his throne.
Exactly. Here we go. Like I say, exactly. Look, okay. On a mommy point of view. Mom, I want to go to the store. Can you take your shirt? Look. I said, no, go to that. You're not getting that. Now, unless you can get up the key and start driving, my friend, then yeah, we can go. But first and foremost, you can't even get that out the door, little six-year-old. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You know, they, oh, yeah, sure. If you can take that key and start driving... Sure enough, go ahead. Go get that Torah.
So then,
if you dare do, you go get Torah.
The clarity in the heavens, in the spiritual thought and reality and manifestation fulfilled this day. As the host of heaven cannot be numbered. Now, a lot of people think that because it doesn't just have to mean it's so many. It's that you don't know.
You can't.
Yeah, there's a lot.
Exactly. You can't even number. And you know what? Again, Stargazer. If you watch Stargazer,
neither
they try to count that shit too.
Neither the sand.
They're like, oh, really? That's a challenge.
Watch, but here's another thing. Even though there are many, only a few are chosen.
Uh-huh.
So, as the host of heaven cannot be numbered, neither the sand of the sea measured, so will I multiply the seed of David, my servant, and the Levites that minister to me. So he's saying, I will multiply them.
Exactly.
So now, having said that, it goes forward to say, moreover. The word, or Jesus Christos, of him that be who he be, his imperial majesty, came to Jeremiah, saying, consider it thou not what this people have spoken, saying, the two families which the Lord hath chosen.
Ooh, Israel.
He hath even cast them off. Are we not in the shitstum or situation we be in?
Yes,
thus they have despised my people.
New world disorder.
No, they have despised my people.
It's out of order.
It's saying, consider thou what these people... He's saying, Jeremiah, check it. You hear what these fools be saying? You say what they say?
Wow.
That I cast my people? You hear them? You hear this foolishness? Then he's like, thus they have despised my people. Because my people are right here testifying on YouTube.
Yeah, and they said, I threw them out.
They're on YouTube. They're on Facebook.
I threw them out. Okay. Oh, they lost? You hear what I said, Jeremiah? They lost. Lost tribe. Lost to who?
That is that they should be
low saints.
That they should
saints
be.
Saints on the low. That's what we got.
Yeah.
I mean, they lost, honey. Saints on the low, honey. You just
yeah, because if they knew who we would be, they'd probably good send us out to kill us quick.
That's why y'all make it fun and quick fast.
No, it says that they should be no more thus they have even cast them off, or that's the question, thus they have despised my people, that they should be no more a nation before them. No, it's kind of like, I will.
They're not gonna see them.
People that ain't no people.
Basically, incognito.
Yeah, people
like shadow government. Just Rastafari. Shadow government, shadow in his shadows, dude. In his shadows, like you know, you like that. You know, when we go into modern culture, yeah, we like that stealth. He's like that ninja. Even in we fucking this bullshit movies, what we are, everybody like that, like espionage. Movies, you know what I mean?
The light,
well,
check it. The light shining in darkness. What causes the shadow?
Oh, the sun.
And what is the shadow? It's the darkness.
Yeah.
But it's caused by the light, yeah. And it's caused by a middleman. You know. So we have the light, which is the Father. Then we have the Son, which we are his shadow.
And we can hide in our shadow. You know,
well, he's the tree, and we under his shadow.
Did you ever hide in your parents' shadow outside? I know it's kind of hard for you.
Well, he's in back and he's in front. He's protecting us.
Exactly. But you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, have you ever been like, oh, I'm in my shadow? Have you ever played the shadows?
Well, that's why I was called.
Sometimes you connected the shadows together. Shadow. Have you ever played shadows with your friends? Like, here, like, we're playing a shadow and then, like, our shadows sit together. I mean, just looking at being in our big brother's shadow. You know what I'm saying? In his reflection. Yeah. We're behind him. We're like hiding behind
him. No, my bad. Here's the thing that I missed, that the Old Testament is a shadow.
Yeah, sorry.
And a shadow of things to come.
And that's where they saw the
But
light.
The real substance is the man that is causing that shadow. So the shadow, you don't really see the clear image.
Sometimes you see a shadow.
You see a form? See
the person. Oh, sometimes if the sun is somewhere, you'll see a big old shadow coming, and then the person starts walking into the
light. But you don't see the person.
Exactly.
Yeah, until you're in the New Testament.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Then in the
they come closer.
But
to
then
you.
In the Book of Life today, then you walk in the person, in the spirit.
Yeah, the newness.
So then it says, thus saith the Lord, if my covenant be not with day and night, and if I have not appointed Serat, the order, Negeshtat of the kingdom, Serat Negeshtat, you know, but the order of the coronation, it that's what it's called,
the Serat. Sound like the
Ser, no, Negeshtat is kingdom.
Oh, so set up the kingdom. If I haven't set up the kingdom,
yeah, if I haven't, well, you know,
established.
It's because the kingdom people just fantasize. People fantasize.
Yeah, because you know, you could like a business plan.
They want a princess and a fairy tale, exactly. And they want a castle and a dragon and shit like that. Well, the dragon comes in the form of the Vatican
But you got to plan the work and park your.
No. Here's the thing.
He did it.
Here's the thing. A kingdom. Just look up the definition.
Okay.
Let's look it up so that get this out of the way. What's a kingdom? And I hope I'm right.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But it's because it's a reign. It's rulership.
Uh-huh.
And that doesn't mean...
It's leadership. It's a responsibility. It's stewardship.
It's a reign of influence. Reign of influence.
Like, he's the leader of... Garbage collecting. Oh, he's the leader of coupon collect. He's the leader of the pack.
Mm-hmm. A kingdom, a country, or a nation whose head, whose Christ, whose Ras is king,
king
of
kings,
or queen.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
A country whose head is king or queen. A realm or region in which something or someone is dominant.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
One of the three primary divisions of lifeless. Now that's something. Oh, lifeless material. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well.
They added some new Websters.
They
got you in the web. No, but what does that say? Let's hear.
No,
that.
but what?
Let's make sense out of
listen,
that.
Listen, in the Lutheran interview with his Manchester. He said, do you have any advice to young ones across the world?
Mm-hmm.
He said very clearly, in this case, I'd like to make it very clear that I don't seek to make distinctions. This goes to everyone. This isn't limited to a particular church. It's not limited to faith boundaries.
Everybody in the sea.
No, he makes it clear who he's talking to. He's talking to his kingdom.
Because
he says,
"But it's
to those to whom I am the King of Kings.
Amen.
So, if he's not your King of Kings, then you're not part of his kingdom.
Exactly.
It's that simple. Exactly. To those, for those
who
to
listen
whom,
to me,
to, who, whom, to whom I am emperor,
who hear my voice,
follow the Ten Commandments.
Follow me. Aye, exactly.
Follow the Ten Commandments. So, what does that mean? That means that you ain't got no shot
your
on
hearts.
Earth. No, no, no. That means that you're not going to go in. Exactly. That means that you failed.
Exactly.
So what is that telling you? What is His Majesty saying? He's saying that to those to whom, for those to whom I am emperor, my advice is for you to follow and keep the Ten Commandments. You know what they are, so expound on them. Uh-huh. And, you know, if you do this, then I would, because this is also what I do and follow, then I would accept that not only we are historically Christian, Hebrew, Ethiopian Hebrew, Israelite, Rastafari Christian, but that we are actively. Now, what is that telling you? Uh-huh. It's code for those to whom it's been revealed, the things hidden, which belong to us, the inheritors of His kingdom. Uh-huh. That's a code word for saying, uh-huh, go through Christ, yeses.
Exactly. But look, it was
go in Yeshua HaMashiach.
It was the head telling the heart to follow. Remember, you said the heart is the Ten Commandments.
Yeah, but we broke them. We broke the heart. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. So basically, that's code for, listen, the only way that you can do this repair is through Yeshua. No, you can't.
It's through Yeshua. The repair, yeah. The reparation, the repair of the breach, the repair of this broken heart.
Well, the thing with what he's saying is that the answer is in the beginning, when he says, we, from time to time, we do make mistakes, we do commit sins. But even as we do this, mm-hmm, we as Christians know that we have the opportunity of forgiveness from the Almighty. Mm-hmm. So basically saying, at the end, he's revealing what he said in the beginning.
We have an advocate.
As Christians, mm-hmm, even though we commit sins and mm-hmm we do make mistakes from time mm-hmm to time, we know as Christians,
yeah,
that we have the possibility of forgiveness from the Almighty. Mm-hmm. And then later on he says, this is what makes me want to follow Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Because he can. But he's setting the example. You cannot fulfill the Ten Commandments.
Exactly.
The law is not for you to want to keep. The law is for you to realize that you need grace and mercy, that you mm-hmm need to go through Yeshua HaMashiach.
Mm-hmm.
Because
mm-hmm
the law condemns the slightest transgression.
Exactly.
With death. No forgiveness. No. It doesn't say,
His Majesty said, don't. I think, you're talking about His Majesty said, don't criticize anyone in their religion, because you don't know what part of the game they playing in, and you bringing in a serpent into the home. You know.
Well, no one's perfect except for God, and He is God. But
don't try to be not.
So basically, being Christ. That's what makes me want to follow Jesus Christ. That He gives you the opportunity. Mm-hmm. That when I tell you later on, follow the Ten Commandments, because first Yeshua was received, then the commandments were mm-hmm given. Mm-hmm. The commandments were for you to see that you ain't worthy.
Mm-hmm.
So you better recognize what's been done for you.
Come serve.
You better recognize and share that love, because you don't deserve it. I just mm-hmm called you out because you're nothing. You're no people, but you're a people because mm-hmm I call you my people. Mm-hmm. So recognize that grace and mercy has been
given. And it's a double entendre. It's like a people with a nation. It's like undercover, but if you really want to stay undercovers and don't come out even to yourself, then you're going to be hidden, and it'll be just passed away in the mist, raptured up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know. We're left, and that just snatched up the person, just to finish up the
Jeremiah part. It says, thus saith the Lord, if my covenant be not with day and night, and if I have not appointed the ordinances of heaven and earth, if mm-hmm not, if, you know, I testify to heaven and earth, you know, that. So basically, listen, you know, if it's not day and night, and if I don't control the, you know, the
I
whole
bet you. I testify to heaven and earth, yeah.
Then will I cast away the seed of Jacob and David my servant, so that I will not take any of his seed to be rulers over the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, for I will cause their captivity to return and have mercy on them. So it's saying, like, if I don't rule heaven and earth, if I don't control day and night, then I won't keep my promise. But because I do, guess what?
Exactly.
I will cause their captivity to return.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They will repent and turn to the east at the rising of the sun
mm-hmm
and have mercy on them.
Yeah,
Here's another thing. In other words, you have to accept that the throne of David is established in Ethiopia because there's no other place.
It's that simple. Where else could be? Amen. I noticed that when I did my studies, I looked in the encyclopedia and there it was. I was like, there it is. Thank you. Even though I was like, is this it? And it started, is this it to Christ? But then Father helped me with the research and continued. So ones and ones, yes.
It was the fleshy manifestation to give hope.
It's not a fairy tale.
To the truth.
Live and real.
Yeah, just as a witness, because he promised.
And we're in this video game. This ain't even real. This is an illusion. So wake up and know that he. Okay, I'm sorry. This is an illusion.